The declaration, in effect, is a friend because it creates the framework in which all the concerns and the relationship between states and indigenous peoples can be dialogued. It creates a framework. It places the issues around indigenous peoples in the context of international law.
We are seeking recognitions for the indigenous people in the Horn of Africa, in the region where the states do not recognize the indigenous people's existence, even to a certain extent.
Strictly speaking, Kenya does not have any indigenous people, because the very definition of indigenous presupposes that those who are not indigenous are foreign.
I think it's wrong for our government to say that there are no indigenous peoples in Kenya, because in the first place, why did they accept that the Sengwer, the Ogiek, and the Chamus are indigenous when they wanted a grant from the World Bank? Because this was one of the conditions from World Bank, that they recognize the indigenous people so that they offer free and prior consent before they do a project in their community, because this was to build a dam amongst the Sengwers. And then the government of Kenya accepted the Sengwer and the Ogiek and the Chamus as indigenous peoples. What about the other the indigenous communities like the Elmolo, Samburu, Maasai, Turkana, and the Rendiles?
We hear that some states, some African and Asian states, say that they are all indigenous to the African and Asian region. We, the Inuit from the Arctic, we know who are the indigenous peoples in these regions, because we see how they live, we know their history, we know that they regard themselves to be indigenous, and we recognize that, because they have this self-identification as indigenous peoples. And I think they deserve to be recognized by their states.
Indigenous peoples, they are people with distinct cultures. They are people that most of them have been dispossessed of their ancestral land. And they are people who have always wanted to live in their own territories. Otherwise, only when they have been forced out of their lands by governments that have ruled them. And indigenous peoples have got a connection with land.
Well, depending on who is calling, these people indigenous. For example, let me take my own country, Namibia. There are two groups that are considered indigenous. If you take the example of the Himba people are the same people like myself. The country was colonized by the Germans. We were, because of this colonization and the interaction with colonial regime, we were exposed, we changed our lifestyle, we changed a lot of things. And the other community that is exactly the same group as us did not. Why should they be more indigenous than I am? We speak the same language, we have exactly the same culture, we have the same history of the way we migrated into the present in Namibia. The only difference that I came into contact with colonization, I got Western education, wearing a suit, they didn't, and they wear traditional costumes or dresses. So if I move back and put on that dress, am I then indigenous? And when I put in a suit, I'm not indigenous. It doesn't make sense.
A definition for indigenous people is not a must, because these people are recognizable. They can be recognized by the government, they can be recognized by their fellow citizens, because these are people who have lived with their cultures and they want to remain that way. And they have been mainly segregated or marginalized because of who they are and where they are.
These are very distinct people. If you look at the way of life of hunters and gatherers, these are people who still hunt and gather in their own ancestral lands. And they still want to stay and live in their own lives.
We need government to work also for us, to recognize us.
There are indigenous peoples in Africa. And there is no doubt about this.
We are pastoralists who raise animals. So we come up with that terminology, and that terminology became widely known, widely accepted, even though there were a lot of debates. Professors in the university say, oh, this is not the right term. And even the prime minister, you know, hijacked the word and said, yes, this is appropriate term. If you have any alternative and better one, come up with it. This is what we got. He said what we got. But it was our invention. It was the collection of the people. And we blessed him. We blessed him, say, good. No matter where the idea comes from, no matter where the term comes from, but if you are speaking that term, you are on the way to recognize our people.
Porque nosotros somos colectividades y esta declaración va dirigido a colectividades, no a personas, ciudadanos de los estados. Esos derechos individuales ya están contemplados en los derechos, en la Declaración Universal de los Derechos Humanos y demás documentos que van en ese sentido en el sistema de la OEA como en el sistema de la ONU. La diferencia aquí de esta declaración es que debe centrar que el sujeto titular del derecho a quien va dirigida esta declaración es a las colectividades, a los pueblos indígenas del mundo. Para fortalecer y reconocer eso que ellos ya reconocen, la diversidad cultural del mundo.
We don't have an exact explanation of peoples or minorities, and we don't even have a definition of indigenous peoples. I think that's the way it should be, but internationally there is some principles that we have to follow. On the other hand, you have to be flexible within the states. So I think it's important that governments and states that have indigenous peoples living in their area, that they give the possibility to have a dialogue with their own peoples there, and try to use the declaration in their own way. That's the purpose of 24 years of struggle drafting this declaration.
Wouldn't you agree that they define themselves as the people?
They certainly do. As a people, yes. As a people, as a distinct people, and a very proud people at that. Yes, they certainly do.
There are ethnic groups in several countries within a region. How do they determine how they affiliate or associate? How do the Pele tribe in Liberia, okay, when they want to affiliate or associate with the Pele tribe in Guinea, okay, which laws of sovereign nation do they fall under? One cannot underestimate the power of tribalism. One cannot underestimate the power of tribalism, especially in Africa, because sometimes the loyalty to one tribe supersedes that of its own national or patriotic loyalties. So we have to protect ourselves in those situations. And that is the thrust of the issue here.